when we first ran for office that we knew and Manitobans knew we had to fix the finances of our province. We inherited a colossal mess, and the reality is that we have worked very, very hard while maintaining and increasing investments in healthcare. Significantly, we've worked, year six as opposed to eight, but I think it's really important to understand that we have invested, this year's budget alone is $1 billion more than the NDP ever put in to health, education, and social services. So repeating the argument of cuts, as Mr. Kinew likes to do, is a desperate ploy and a political statement, but it's not reflective of reality. The reality is that we are investing record amounts in healthcare, and we're committed to investing $2 billion more in our coming term because we want better results for Manitoba patients, and we don't deserve the longest waits in Canada here in Manitoba.
When you look at the promises we've made, they do one of two things. One is they either improve economic growth or they help people save money. One of those two things, basically, and everything we're trying to do. But the fact is that Manitoba needs, we need something more than just more of the same. And we've seen what more of the same looks like. We saw it today. It was really no different than the arguing back and forth of people blaming one another. We have to have ideas and we have to have actual solutions for climate change especially. I actually find it appalling. I think the NDP has completely abandoned any responsibility for this in saying they're just going to plunder hydro and hand out money like they're dropping it from a helicopter while doing nothing, making no concrete commitments to actually doing anything on climate change. It's the single most important issue because if we don't actually have a livable environment, nothing else is going to matter.
When you reduce the price of something, you increase the demand for it. This is economics 101. So when we make Manitoba hydropower cheaper, we know that there'll be an incentive there for people to use more of it. And that'll factor in when they start making that decision to buy the next vehicle, right? It'll be more attractive to buy a hybrid vehicle. It'll be more attractive to buy an all-electric vehicle, even weatherizing your home, improving your furnace. I want to give it up to Manitobans, the choice to decide what's the next step that they're going to take to improve the environment, because I think everybody wants to take action. It's just that we need to help move people into that action by giving them a little bit more resources, a little bit more cash in hand to do so.
I do think it went a little bit too much to talking points tonight. You know, the Premier didn't really answer my question. Yeah, poverty rates have declined slightly, but that's because of the Canada Child Benefit, not because of anything the Premier has done. In fact, to the contrary of what he's done, Mr. Kinew's climate plan is just, it's terrible. It's absolutely terrible. It's really no different than the federal proposal in the sense that the feds are going to give a $300 rebate back. He's going to give you $350 on your hydro bill, but it's almost one and the same. It's worse than the original PC plan, which is going to be a $25 a ton carbon credit, carbon tax. Beyond that, I don't see how he has any hopes of negotiating. I mean, the feds have been very clear, so I see no idea how he has any hopes of negotiating such a deal with the federal government unless he's hoping for Andrew Scheer to be elected prime minister.